Hello students, looking at current affairs for 15th May. So the important keywords which have been picked up from today's newspaper are here in front of us. First one is Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. So this is the tranche 2 of the scheme which has been announced now. So Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, she announced the tranche 1. Yesterday we saw it in news, and now this is tranche 2, which is for migrant workers, small businesses, street vendors and farmers. So, for migrant workers, basically free food grains have been announced through the PDS, and this will be part of the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, which has been extended with free food grains to migrant workers. So, in the same context, One Nation, One Ration Card scheme is also in use. This was initiated by the central government much before this crisis, and it proposed to have interoperability of ration cards. Ration cards are actually issued by the state government, and ration card, a migrant worker in one state will not have access to PDS food grains in another state. So if there is ration card interoperability, that would be possible. So that was the scheme which was proposed to cover all the states by June 2020. But now the finance minister has announced this would be delayed and will cover all beneficiaries by March 2021. So this is there. Then next is PM Mudra Yojana. So this is a scheme for affordable loans, for mudra loans. So this loans are for small businesses. This is also segregated into three categories, that is mudra, shishu, kishore and tarun. So loans up to 50,000 come under shishu, 50,000 to 5 lakh under kishore, and more than 5 lakh to up to 10 lakh is under mudra tarun. So for small businesses, even 2% interest subvention has been announced by the finance minister under Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. Then e-office is in use. E-office is actually initiated under National E-Governance Plan. It's a mission mode project under National E-Governance Plan, initiated in 2009. It has been developed and implemented by NIC, National Informatics Center. So it actually ensures that there is no redundancy of data storage and information sharing and interoperability amongst government organizations. So the way government works, they can also work online. So e-office has been put into effect and has been used by various government departments, central government departments presently. And the idea of work at home may be extended later too is what is being proposed. So that is in use, that eligible staff can work from home 15 days a year. The scheme would stay work at home. Then next is COBA 6800. So this is actually a testing technology which we have procured. And it has been established at National Center for Disease Control. So the Health Minister Mr. Vardhan dedicated it to the nation. And Chitra Gene Lamp Pen is actually an indigenous COVID-19 testing technology which has been developed by an Indian institution. So this is Sri Chitra Thirunal Institute for Medical Science and Technology, which is in Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala. So but presently the news is that this technology will require further testing and will be available in few weeks. And then you have regarding Gilgit-Baltistan region. So this is the Pakistan-occupied Kashmir region, and presently Pakistan has proposed to build a dam here, and that is the Daimar Bhasha Dam. So this Daimar Bhasha Dam is being built on Indus River and will provide irrigation facilities once ready to Pakistan. But since it is in Gilgit-Baltistan region, in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir region, so India's question of territorial integrity arises. And here India has raised concerns with China, because the Chinese company has been roped in for this project by Pakistan. So that is it. These are the key important keywords. We'll look at the detailed current affairs now. So here we'll look at the important news items. These are the important headlines which have been picked up from the Hindu newspaper. We look at them in detail. The first one is migrant workers to get free food grain stimulus for small businesses, street vendors and farmers. So this is in the context of second tranche of the economic stimulus package which has been announced, which is Atmanirbhar Abhiyan. So for migrant workers, what it seeks to provide is free food grains for the next 2 months to migrant workers who do not have ration cards. So center is going to spend 3,500 crore for this purpose. So they will be getting free food grains. It is estimated that around 8 crore migrant workers who are housed in various government and privately run relief camps across the country since the lockdown will benefit out of it.
Also, this is said to be an extension of the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, which was announced by the government on March 27. So, it had proposed additional monthly free rice or wheat allocation of 5 kg per person and 1 kg pulse per household. So, this has been extended to migrant workers who do not have ration cards. Also, states have been directed by the finance minister to enroll migrant workers under the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Also, regarding ration card portability scheme, finance minister announced that it would be covering all beneficiaries now by March 2021. Originally, it was supposed to cover all states by June 2020. So, this is regarding the One Nation, One Ration Card scheme, which we discussed, which will provide interoperability of these PDS systems. And migrant workers who are working in another state can also avail PDS food grains. Then next is announcement for affordable housing. So, Finance Minister has announced a scheme to build rental housing complexes through public-private partnership mode under the existing Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Means rental houses would be built on government or private land, and this will be PPP which will be initiated. So, even existing government housing will be converted into rental units. Means this is for migrant workers and other urban poor. Means they will get not rent free houses, but houses which they can take on rent. So this is there. And also credit linked subsidy scheme has been proposed for lower middle class under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, which is already there, which has been extended by 1 year to March 2021. So this is also a credit linked subsidy scheme, means loan, subsidized loan will be provided to lower middle class for housing. So again, how much appetite lower middle class would have to take a loan for housing presently is to be seen, because what is being seen is there should be money in the hands of the poor so that they can spend, and they are not going to take loans to spend. So, Finance Minister says that this would also create jobs, because if people are taking loans and building houses, then there will be a demand for steel, cement and construction industries, and create jobs and give boost to the economy through lower middle class housing. Then next is for street vendors. So for street vendors, what it proposes is again loan, easy credit through a 5,000 crore scheme. So it will be offering 10,000 rupees loans for initial working capital to street vendors. Means it is expected to benefit 50 lakh street vendors. Means street vendors are expected to take loan as presently. And for small businesses who have taken loans under the Mudra Shishu scheme, which is meant for loans worth 50,000 or less, they will receive a 2% interest subvention relief for the next year. So this is going to be a 2% less of interest for them, those who have already taken loans. So this is going to cost the government 1,500 crores. So this is incentive being given. And for farmers, the center plans to drive to enroll 2.5 crore farmers who are not yet part of Kisan credit card schemes, along with fish workers and livestock farmers, and provide them with 2 lakh crore worth of concessional credit. So again, loans are proposed for farmers too. Even NABARD is going to extend additional refinance support worth 30,000 crore to rural banks for crop loans. So these are all credit schemes which have been announced. The announcements have been criticized. It says the only fiscal outlay in today's announcements are of 3,500 crores for food grains for migrants and 1,500 crore for Mudra loans, which is the interest subvention. So apart from this 5,000 crores, government has all other proposals based on credit, providing loans. So the experts, economists say that at a time when demand is down, any move to provide liquidity is not going to help, because that is not the problem. RBI has been trying to boost and push liquidity into the economy through the banks, but banks are parking money with them. They are not having any appetite, and people are also not having any appetite to take credit at this time. And banks also do not want to take risk. So liquidity is not the problem, but putting cash in the hands of the people would be a better approach, is what is being suggested. So this is the gist of what we just discussed. And this is regarding One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. So it's Aadhaar linked. So it will require even Aadhaar EKYC verification through POS, point of sale devices. So that may create glitches too, but it is proposed to be implemented nationwide. Now this date has changed, as you saw, from 1st July 2020 to 31st March 2020. And this is regarding Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana. Then this is Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana, which was launched by the government in 2015 to extend affordable credit to micro and small enterprises. So it provides loans up to maximum up to rupees 10 lakh. So there are three categories under Mudra loans too. That is Shishu, Kishore and Tarun. So up to 50,000, the scheme 2% interest subvention is for these Shishu Mudra loans. These are for startups and first time entrepreneurs. Then Kishore is for a loan of 50,000 to 5 lakh and Tarun for 5 lakh to 10 lakh loans. The next is NHRC issues notices to states. So National Human Rights Commission has issued notices to Maharashtra government over inappropriate approach adopted for the release of prisoners to avoid SARS-CoV infection. So Maharashtra government has proposed release of prisoners. So NHRC is questioning the state government on this. And even Madhya Pradesh government has been questioned over an incident of a pregnant migrant giving birth on the road. So pregnant migrants have been walking back to their hometowns and villages, and this pregnant woman, she gave birth on the road, and after 2 hours rest she continued her work. So the plight of the migrant workers is highlighted in this, and NHRC has asked chief secretaries of both states for a report in 4 weeks. Then next is work from home may stay for government staff. So post-lockdown, Union government will continue staggered and variable work hours for its employees. And there is a draft consultation paper which has been floated by Ministry of Personnel on best work from home practices. So option for work from home will be there to eligible officers and other employees for 15 days a year as a matter of policy even after the lockdown is over. So employees can work at home, but they cannot process classified papers and files. And NIC will, National Informatics Center will evaluate the existing security protocol for remote access of classified files and information to how it can be done. So this is for central government employees. There are around 48.34 lakh central government employees. And it is said at present about 75 ministries and departments are actively using e-office platform. So this is regarding the e-office initiative as such too, which is actually a mission mode project under National E-Governance Plan. So it was initiated in 2009, developed and implemented by NIC, National Informatics Center. So it has been established as a single product for reuse in government. So government departments can use it. It helps in integration, interoperation, prevents duplication of efforts and, you know, redundant data storage, data being stored by every organization. So it promotes intra-government information sharing and it reduces paperwork as well. So it has various components under it, you can see like e-file, e-leave, e-tour, etc. So this is e-office, which is being used presently during the lockdown and has proved beneficial for work from home in government departments. The next is doubling time slows to 13.9 days. So ETI, it is said, has registered an average of over 3,500 new cases every day since May 7th. And this doubling time as such has reduced, has increased. So number of cases are doubling at a slower pace now. So from 11.1 days, it is now 13.9 days, it is said. Fatality rate is said to be around 3.2% and recovery rate around 36%. Then this is regarding Cobas 6800, which is the testing machine which has been dedicated to the nation by Health Minister Harshvardhan. So this has been placed at National Center for Disease Control. So, Cobas 6800 is a fully automated high-end machine for performing real-time PCR testing, polymerase chain reaction testing for COVID-19. So, it has a high throughput of tests also. Around 1200 samples can be tested in 24 hours. So, this is that. And next is regarding the indigenous virus diagnostic test which is being developed, which is called Chitra Gene Lamp N. So this has been developed by Sri Chitra Thirunal Institute for Medical Science and Technology, Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. It has been funded by Department of Science and Technology. So it is using a technology called LAMP, Loop Mediated Isothermal Amplification. So objective as such is to detect the presence of viral RNA for diagnosis of COVID-19. So same as is used in reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction tests. So this LAMP method is said to be faster, but it's a new technology and more complications are there in its design. So it has to be extensively tested. So it may be delayed presently. So RT-PCR tests, actually they focus on two different genes, the envelope gene and RNA dependent RNA polymerase gene. World Health Organization also recommends these two tests, but US Center for Disease Control and Prevention requires even an N-gene test. So N-gene test is a confirmatory test. So design then becomes complicated and expensive. So what this Chitra Gene Lamp N is doing, it is conducting a test on rather than three regions of N-gene, it is conducting tests on two. So it will be cheaper and quicker. Presently, it is being tested. The next is Navy's personal protective equipment gets patent. So this is PPE, personal protective equipment, a low-cost PPE which has been designed and produced by Navy. So it has received a patent for it and will be now mass-produced. So patent was successfully filed by Intellectual Property Facilitation Center of Defense Ministry along with National Research Development Corporation of Ministry of Science and Technology. So PPE has been main problem. The shortage of PPE for healthcare workers during the COVID-19 pandemic is a major issue. So this may be resolved because of this low cost PPE being designed now, patented, but it has to be mass produced. Then next is president to forego 30% salary for a year. So President Ramnath Kovind has decided to forego 30% of his salary for the whole year, apart from directing officials to adopt other austerity measures in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic. Like his domestic tours will be reduced, guest lists will be cut, food menu at official ceremonies would be cut, and also the plan to purchase a new presidential limousine worth 10 crore rupees has been deferred. So that will be done later. Then next is, virus may never go away, warns World Health Organization. So World Health Organization has warned that COVID-19 may never go away. Vaccines are being developed, treatments are being developed, and death toll in the disease has crossed 3 lakh now. European Union is also saying that vaccine would be ready in a year, but the virus, it is said, may just become another endemic virus in our communities and may never go away. So World Health Organization has given this warning. It says the way HIV has not gone away, but we have come to terms with the virus, is what would happen to COVID too. So US also again has initiated another crisis by accusing China of stealing its research on COVID-19 vaccine, which China refutes. So earlier it accused China of releasing this, of the handling of COVID-19 crisis, how it initiated from China and China being held responsible for it. And now it accuses China of stealing its research work. Then next is, India reminds China of claims over Gilgit-Baltistan. So this is regarding Gilgit-Baltistan region, which is in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. So here you have the map of Jammu and Kashmir. This is Aksai Chin region, which is under Chinese control. So China acquired this region from us during the Indo-China war. And this is Shaksgam Valley, which is part of POK, which has been handed over by Pakistan to China. So these regions are under Chinese control. Then Gilgit and Baltistan region are of POK. Pakistan occupied Kashmir, which are under Pakistan control presently, but India has claims over them. And these are Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh regions in which are under Indian government control. So this Gilgit-Baltistan region is being claimed by India, and there is this Dyamar Bhasha Dam, which has been proposed to be constructed here in this Gilgit-Baltistan region along the Indus River, which is going to provide irrigation facilities to Pakistan. So this project has been undertaken with Chinese cooperation. Power China, which is one of biggest Chinese power companies, has received a contract to build this dam. So India has objected to this, raised its concern with this China, because it passes through Gilgit-Baltistan region, which is a disputed territory. So this is the Amar Bhasha Dam here. The next is short service commission to be made more attractive. So as part of measures to reduce the mounting pension burden of the army, short service commission, it is proposed, will be made more attractive, is what Chief of Defence Staff Bipin Rawat has announced. So currently short service commission is for 10 years, can be extended up to 4 years, means it gets 14 years short service commission, and then can option is there of permanent commission. So now it is said that there will be courses, professional or technical courses like MBA, MTech, which will be given to the staff, short service commission staff, to develop skills for second employment. So about 25 to 35% of short service commission officers would be granted permanent commission, and remaining as such would be finding jobs elsewhere, so that pension burden of the army can be reduced. And last news is UK High Court rejects Vijay Mallya's plea. So UK High Court has rejected a plea by businessman Vijay Mallya for permission to move Supreme Court against the dismissal of his appeal challenging the lower court's approval of his extradition to India in IDBI fraud case. So lower court has approved his extradition in UK. The High Court has also approved it and has rejected his appeal in Supreme Court. So High Court said that prima facie case was made out against Vijay Mallya for fraud, misrepresentation to the bank in securing credit facilities, conspiracy and money laundering. So CBI and Enforcement Directorate have also alleged that between September 1, 2009 to January 24, 2017, Vijay Mallya conspired with others to commit cheating and fraudulently got loans sanctioned from the bank to now defunct Kingfisher Airlines. And this was with the intention to not repay them. He made false representations to the banks on Kingfisher Airlines' financial condition and value and on availability of securities and procured these loans and diverted and laundered them. Did not use it for the purpose sanctioned. So these are the allegations against Vijay Mallya. He had taken a loan of about 6,027 crores from SBI-led consortium of banks between 2005 and 2010 for Kingfisher Airlines. And now with interest, this amount is over 9,000 crores. And it is said he laundered this money, diverted this money to shell companies in nearly 7 countries. So it's presently in UK and the High Court has given its ruling for extradition. So we'll have to wait and see how soon this extradition takes place. So that is it. Thank you.